Hello, my dear listeners. Very, very good morning to all of you. As per your demand, I have made a video lecture for you on thermodynamics. Let us start. What is thermodynamics? Thermodynamics, made from two words, thermal plus dynamics. Dynamics. Thermal means heat energy, and dynamics means motion, and motion means work done, and this work done means mechanical work. So, science of thermodynamics is mainly concerned with the transformation of heat energy into mechanical work and vice versa. So, we can say thermodynamics is that branch of science in which we study about the transformation of heat energy into mechanical work and vice versa. Now, before entering into the depth of the thermodynamics, I would like to discuss some basic terms that are frequently used. The most frequently used terms are, number one, system and surroundings. System and surroundings. What is system and what is surrounding? Any part of the universe which is under our study, and is separated from the rest of the universe with a boundary surface is called system, and the rest of the universe is called surroundings. For example, if we take this room as a system, then except this room, the other parts of the universe is called surroundings. Systems, there are three types of systems. Number one, open system. Open system. Open system. Open system is that system in which exchange of both matter and energy can take place between the system and the surroundings. For example, evaporation of water contained in a beaker is an example of open system. For example, let us see, here is the beaker, and beaker contains evaporated water, like this, and vapor is coming out from this beaker. So, beaker containing evaporated water consists of system, and the rest of this beaker is the surroundings. Here, the exchange of both matter and energy are taking place between the system and the surrounding. So, it is an example of open system. Next is closed system. Closed system. What is closed system? A closed system is that system in which only exchange of energy can take place between the system and the surroundings. There is no exchange of matter between the system and the surroundings. For example, if you take a beaker containing evaporated water, and if the beaker is closed, then there may be exchange of only energy and not the matter that may take place between the system and the surrounding. This is an example of closed system. Next is isolated system. Isolated system. Isolated system is that system in which there is neither exchange of matter nor energy between the system and the surroundings. For example, let us imagine a beaker containing evaporated water, and this beaker is insulated, surrounded by non-conducting jacket, so that there may be no exchange of matter, no exchange of energy between the system and the surrounding. Here we see that there is no exchange of matter takes place between the system and the surrounding. So this is an example of isolated system. So isolated system is that system in which neither the exchange of matter nor the energy that can take place between the system and the surrounding. Such system is called isolated system. What is macroscopic system? Macroscopic system means on a large scale. Therefore, this term is used to convey the sense of appreciable quantities, that is quantities which can be weighed. So a system is said to be macroscopic when it consists of large number of molecules, atoms or ions. Even a drop of water is a macroscopic properties, is a macroscopic system, as it may contain greater than 10 to the power 21 water molecules. Homogeneous and heterogeneous system. What is homogeneous system? A system is said to be homogeneous when it is completely uniform throughout the system. For example, a pure solid or a liquid or a solution or a mixture of gases is an example of homogeneous system. A homogeneous system consists of only one phase in which every part of the system has same composition. What is heterogeneous system? A system is said to be heterogeneous when it is not uniform throughout the system. In other words, a heterogeneous system is one which consists of two or more phases. For example, a system consisting of two or more immiscible liquids or a solid in contact with a liquid in water, which does not dissolve, is a heterogeneous system. Another example is that a liquid in contact with its vapor is also an example of heterogeneous system, as it consists of two phases, water and vapor. Another example is water enclosed in a vessel with its contact with ice, solid, water and water vapor. This system is a heterogeneous system, as it has three phases, solid, liquid and gases. For example, here is the beaker. And this beaker contains some water like this, and this is the solid, ice and water vapor. So this is an example of heterogeneous system. Another terms that are frequently used is macroscopic properties. The properties associated with macroscopic system, that is consisting of large number of particles, are called macroscopic properties. These properties are pressure P, volume V, temperature T, composition, that is concentration, density, viscosity, surface tension, refracting index, color, etc. The next term that are used is the state of a system. What is the state of a system? When macroscopic properties of a system like pressure, volume, temperature have definite values, the system is said to be in a definite state. Whenever there is a change in any one or more of the macroscopic properties, the system is said to have undergone a change of state. The system is defined by its macroscopic properties, is now definitely in different state. The next term is state variables. Since the state of a system changes with change in any one of the macroscopic properties, these properties are called state variables. It also follows that when a system changes from one state called initial state to another state called final state, there is invariably a change in one or more of the macroscopic properties. Pressure, temperature, volume, mass and composition are the most important state variables. For example, here is the system. It has pressure P, volume V and temperature T. This is initial state. Initial state. And this system changes to another state which has pressure P2, volume V2 and temperature T2. This is the final state. Final state. Independent and dependent variables. The next terms are independent and dependent variables. Pressure, temperature, volume, and mass and composition are the most important state variables. In actual practice, it is not necessary to specify all the state variables because they are all interrelated. And only some of them need to be independent. In the case of single gas, composition is not one of the variables because it remains always 100%. Further, if the gas is ideal and one mole of the gas is under examination, it obeys the gas equation PV equal to RT. PV is equal to RT. This equation PV equal to RT, here R is the universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. constant. In this equation, if any two of the three terms are known, then third can be easily calculated. Here, the specified term pressure, temperature, and volume. Pressure and temperature are the two terms that are independent, and volume is the dependent variables. Here, pressure and temperature are independent variables, and volume is the dependent variables. Dependent variables. Thus, here pressure, volume, and temperature, any two of these three terms are known, then third can be easily calculated. Here, pressure and temperature are the independent variables, and volume is the dependent variables. And the next term that are generally used is extensive and intensive properties. And extensive and intensive properties. What is extensive property and what is intensive property? Extensive property, that property of the system which depends on the mass of the system. Which depends on the mass of the system. The, for example, mass, amount of substance, mole, energy, volume, internal energy, enthalpy H, entropy S, heat capacity, Cp and Cv, Gibbs free energy, G, Helmholtz free energy, capital A or capital F. These are extensive properties. The extensive property of a single pure substance depends upon the number of moles in of the substance present, and also on any two of the three variables, pressure, volume, and temperature, called independent variables. If n is kept constant, the extensive property of the system will depend only on two independent variables. Intensive property. The intensive property is that property of the system which is independent of mass of the system, that is amount of the substance present in the system. The examples are temperature T, pressure P, volume, vapor pressure Vp, molality small m, melting point and boiling point, concentration, density, surface tension, viscosity, refracting index, specific heat, capacity, etc. How will you check whether the given property of a system is an extensive property or an intensive property? The first is that if one reducing the amount of a substance to half, the concerned property also reduced to half. It is an extensive property. And if on reducing amount of substance to half, the magnitude of the concerned property remains the same, it is an intensive property. For example, mass or volume of water contained in a container is an intensive property. Second is, if a system under examination is a solution of two or more substances, The extensive property will vary with the number of moles Na, Nb, Nc, etc. of the constituent A, B, A, C, etc. present in the system. Also with the two independent variables. The intensive property in such cases will depend upon the concentration of various species beside the two independent variables. And the third is that if the ratio of the two extensive property is an intensive property, for example, density is equal to mass by volume. Density is equal to mass by volume, and mass is an extensive property, and volume is also an extensive property. So if the ratio is both the ratio of both extensive property, then that quantity will be an intensive property. So density is an intensive property. What is thermodynamic equilibrium? A system is in which the microscopic properties do not undergo any change with time is said to be in thermodynamic equilibrium. Let us suppose that a system is heterogeneous, that is, it consists of more than one phase, then it is in equilibrium. And if it is in equilibrium, the macroscopic properties in the various phases remain unaltered with time. The term thermodynamic equilibrium implies the existence of three kinds of equilibria in the system. These are thermal equilibrium, mechanical equilibrium, and chemical equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium. A system is said to be in thermal equilibrium if there is no flow of heat from one portion of the system to the another portion of the system. This is possible only when the temperature remains the same throughout in all the parts of the system. That is, when the temperature is same throughout the system, then there is no flow of heat from one part of the system to the another part of the system. Then this type of equilibrium is said to be thermal equilibrium. And the second is mechanical equilibrium. What is mechanical equilibrium? A system is said to be in mechanical equilibrium if no mechanical work is done by one part of the system or on another part of the system. This is possible if the pressure remains constant same in all parts of the system throughout. Once again, what is mechanical equilibrium? A system is said to be in mechanical equilibrium if no mechanical work is done by one part of the system on another part of the system. This is possible if the pressure remains constant, that is, pressure remains same in all parts of the system throughout. Such type of system is called mechanical equilibrium. And chemical equilibrium. A system is said to be in chemical equilibrium if the composition of the various phases in the system remains the same throughout in the system. And some basic terms, some processes in thermodynamics that are frequently used. The process or the operation by which a system changes from one state to another state is called a process. The operation by which a system changes from one state to another state is called a process. Whenever a system changes from one part of the to another part or one state to another state, it is accompanied by a change in energy. The following types of processes are well known in thermodynamics. They are isothermal process. What is isothermal process? Isothermal process This process is made from this isothermal. This isothermal is made from two words, isos plus thermal. Isos, this means same, and thermal means heat, and heat means temperature. So same temperature throughout the system. So isothermal process is that process in which temperature remains constant throughout the process. That is, in isothermal process, temperature is maintained constant by the transfer of heat between the system and the surrounding. Such process is called isothermal process. Once again, isothermal process is that process in which temperature of the system is maintained constant by the transfer of heat between the system and the surrounding. The best example is Boyle's law. Boyle's law, that is PV is equal to a constant. When P is constant, this is the Boyle's law. The Boyle's law is an example of isothermal process. The next term that are frequently used is adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. Adiabatic process is that process in which no heat is allowed to enter or to leave the system. That is, heat absorbed or heat released by the system will be equal to zero. That is, dQ is equal to zero. Or dQ is equal to zero. Where dQ, heat absorbed or heat released by the system. And the next term is isobaric process. Isobaric process. Isobaric process. Isobaric process is that process in which pressure of the system remains constant. This isobaric is made from two words, isos plus bar. Isos means same and bar means pressure. So same pressure throughout the system. So isobaric process is that process in which pressure of the system remains constant throughout the process. That is, dp will be equal to zero in this process. Isochoric process. Next is isochoric process. Isochoric process. Isochoric process is that process in which volume of the system remains constant throughout the process. That is dV into zero. And then next is cyclic process. Cyclic process. A cyclic process is that process in which the system, after performing a series of operations, comes back to its initial state. That is, the system is brought back to the initial state. Suppose the system starts from A, it absorbs some heat Q, and this work does some work W. And then the system reaches the state B, and from this state B it goes to another state C, then another state D, and then another state E, then it reaches to state A. That is, system does a series of work W1, W2, W3, W4 and W5, and then the system reaches the initial state A. So this is an example of cyclic process. And since in this case the system reaches the initial state, so change in internal energy of the system will be equal to zero. That is, dE is equal to zero in cyclic process. For cyclic process, we have change in internal energy of the system is equal to zero. From first law of thermodynamics, dq is equal to dE plus dW. And for cyclic process, this is equal to zero. So this is equal to dW. Therefore, dq is equal to dw, and integration